Yo, what's up with y'all, man? It's Ari from Gammas, back with another video. Now, as you can obviously tell, I'm not in my normal setup right now. I'm actually in Los Angeles for a little bit, probably for like a couple more weeks. Usually I got the little Goku bobblehead, the Goku in the back, but I still got the Goku on me. Today's video, we're gonna be doing something a little different. We're gonna be doing a top 10 Air Forces of all time, or at least my personal favorite. All of these shoes in this list, I will own in the next few coming years. Never really pop up. So we're gonna jump onto the top 10. Start off number 10, we got the Air Force One UTT Clowns or the Ethiopia. A lot of people don't like them. I like them more in person. If you see them in pictures, they're kind of just like kind of bland, the red and the blue. You might not say it doesn't go really well or it's not a good mix, but I actually really like them. I think they're clean. I think the leather is really crispy and the white outline around the stitching, I actually think they actually looks really good in my opinion. I don't know why. It gives them more like a premium feel to it, you know what I'm saying? And they're a lot more different than other Air Forces around there. So the placement of the logo, I think is actually pretty unique too. It's just one of those slept on Air Forces. The fact that they're premium and a lot of people kind of not feeling them. Nah, man, I think these are really nice. Especially when you see an actual picture in hand, like the leather is actually really crispy on these. So number 10, we got the UTT Clowns. At number 9, we got the Air Force One Rockefeller. You most likely know about these. They're actually very simple. They're probably the most simple one on this list. I think I said this in another video, that there are only all white Air Forces that have like very premium leather on them. And you know me, man, I've been saying this for the past couple of videos, man. That's like the main thing for me. They're kind of expensive now. They used to be a lot cheaper back then for some reason, but I think the price went up to like $400 or $500 now. They're kind of slipping away, I'm not gonna lie, but I mean, I'ma have them. I'ma have them for sure. So at number 9, we got the Air Force One Rockefeller. At number 8, we got the Air Force One Christmas. Now, when I first seen these, I thought these was ugly, like most people. And I also thought, well, what the hell does this got to do with Christmas? But I don't know what it is, man. I like the red. I don't have a lot of red sneakers. Like, I got a lot of sneakers, but it's kind of a weird thing. I'm just not a big fan of red sneakers anymore. For these are a lot different. I think they have like a mesh and leather combination on the upper. The midsole is white. Honestly, Air Force One has to have a white midsole. If it doesn't, it's automatically kind of weak to me. But man, I think these are very cool. And again, I don't know what it has to do with Christmas, but it's better than the other Christmas, the Miz that came out. Those are terrible. I think these came out like 2006, and they're nice. A lot of people don't like them because of the color patterns or just the detail around them, but I think they actually look really good, man. I actually really, really like these, and they're not even that expensive. They were actually a GR release, I think back in 06 or 07, and they're really cool. I actually really like these a lot. So at number 8, we got the Air Force One Christmas. So me being kind of dumb, I almost left number 7 out of the video. I almost skipped over it and almost didn't make it. But at number 7, we got the Air Force One Halloweens from 2006. I did a review of the women's Halloween Air Force One, but these are the men's that have black, have orange, man. Those grew on me a lot. Those came out after the ones with the yellow, you know, they were like the same color, but they were both the same. They were orange in the back and black in the front. I don't like those, but these half orange, half black ones, man, they really grew on me. I like the patent leather and they look really good only when they're brand new, honestly, but I like them. I like the patch on the side, that little creepy thing. I don't know what it is, like a skeleton or something, but those are really nice, man. They're not as good as the women's ones. Still, I still like those a lot more, but I gotta say these grew on me a lot. And definitely trying to get my hands on them. They're not even that expensive either, but they are very old. So you gotta get them like kind of brand new, you know what I mean? But they're very nice, man. So at number 7, you get the Air Force One Halloween from 2006. At number 6, we got the Air Force One Sashiko Paranoise or Paranoia. I don't know how to say that second word. These are actually so creative in my opinion. These are probably the most creative ones on the list. These just look just eye-popping, just all the colors on them. The materials are so different. Honestly, I've never seen them in hand. I've only seen them in pictures. I don't know if they were an international release only. These look really good. They have like gold, blue, like dark navy blue, white, gray. This just looks really good in my opinion, man. Honestly, when things have like a Japanese tone to it, I don't know why they just catch my eye a little more, especially when it comes to Air Force Ones, because there are a lot of colorways like that. I want to see these in person, and I can't wait to review them too, because like I said in the beginning of the vid, I'm going to own every single Air Force One in this list for sure. So at number 6, we got the Air Force One Sashiko Paranoids. At number 5, we got the Air Force One Surigami. Honestly, I don't even know if that's the real name of them. I don't even know what they look like in person, but the only way I could find what these are called, I had to translate a couple words into Google, and that's the first thing to pop up was Surigami. And it was really hard to find pictures about these. A lot of people don't really know about them. And honestly, these would be higher on the list if they were at least a little bit more, I'm not even gonna say affordable, because I don't know the price on these. But if they were a little bit more known and if they appeared more on the internet, you know what I mean? I can't find a certain price. I could barely find even pictures of them. They're really, really rare, man. Again, like I said in the last one, these got the little Japanese or Asian tone to it. And I think that looks really good, man. I can tell that it has a lot of like details around them with like outlines all over the place. That thing looks crazy, man. Like I said, these would be like top 3 if they were a little bit more known. Or a little bit more out there, you know what I mean? It just seems like they're gonna be really hard for me to get my hands on these and actually do a review. But when I do, I think these will be higher on my list of my personal favorites of all time, because these just look crazy, man. Super clean, very rare, like I said, but man, these are clean. These are really, really good. So at number 5, we get the Air Force One Surigami. So at number 4, we got ones that are a little bit more affordable, a lot more known. We got the Air Force One Manchester B. Now, I'm a big fan of tan, white, brown. These just put them colors all the way together. And if you know me, you know I like that patch on the side. That patch looks crazy, man. They got a little like hexagon B like imprints on the back. These look crazy, man. And the leather looks really good on them too, man. These, like I said, these are a lot more affordable. Sooner or later, I'm gonna have these for sure. Really, really nice, man. Tan, it kind of remind me of like a different take of the Kif Air Forces. And man, you know, I love them Kif Air Forces. So these look great. Really, really nice colorway, very clean. So at number 4, we got the Air Force One Manchester B. So at number 3, we got the Air Force One Lux or LUX. With the Italian leather on it, man. These are, I ain't gonna lie, they were kind of ugly when I first seen them. And hey, you could still say they're kind of ugly. When I first saw them, I'm like, man, they're kind of weird looking. But I did some more research on them and I saw more pictures. The shape is very different. And the fact that they're only Air Force One, or I think like one of 3 Air Force Ones to feature Italian leather on them. Jesus, a different level of premium, man. I think they run for about like 500, but I know like for a fact that I could find them a lot cheaper too. And these just seem like one of those shoes you step out and you want to stun on somebody, because they might not know what the hell they are, and you can tell them what they are, tell them they're Italian leather on your feet, and they gotta respect that. So at number 3, we got the Air Force One LUX or Lux. I really don't know which one is the right pronunciation, but I'm gonna say the Lux. At number 2, we got the Air Force One Year of the Monkey. I'm starting to believe that they're pretty rare. I'm trying to come across one of them, and it's been a couple years now. These are really cool. Like I told you before, I'm a big fan of brown, and I don't know what it is about these. They're pretty simple, actually. They just have the monkey head on the side. The leather, honestly, it does not look like the best leather. And the design is the only thing that really gets me, but it's to the point where I really, really want them. I like the Nike check a lot too. The fact that it fades from tan to brown. One thing I do gotta say though is the quality on the midsole. For some reason, every pair that I see is terrible. You know, the paint just like goes way too low, or it overlaps. You know what I mean? Like the outsole and the midsole just overlap each other. It's kind of weird, but I'm not gonna lie, I still really like them. So, man, these are just really good. They're just white and brown, very simple. And these are actually really cool, man. Cool enough that they just make them in my top 3. So at number 2, we got the Air Force One Year of the Monkey. Now, at number 1, this has been a shoe that I've been chasing for years now. Can't seem to get my hands on them. The Air Force One Chamber of Fear Hype. I like all the Chamber of Fears. You know, these are actually very known. You know, a lot of Air Force One sneakerheads and in general know about the Chamber of Fear pack. Comes with these, the other purple ones, the green ones, the two red ones, and the, what's the other one? The gray ones, the gray and blue ones. And I've had about like two pairs of them. I have the green ones and I had the other purple ones. And I can never seem to get my hands on these. This has been like my grail at this point, because I can't seem to find them and they just tease me every day. The whole Chamber of Fear pack released in like 06, I think. And actually, I'm just waiting for them to re-release at this point. They said they were gonna re-release like three times. You know how many times I looked on Google and he said that? So Nike has been kind of like teasing people with that release. Man, I'm just hoping that one day they do, because I can't wait to get my hands on these, man. These are definitely a grail. I love these, man. And number one, we got the Air Force One Chamber of Fear hype. So that's it for the list, man. This is my personal favorites. I actually changed the list a couple of times because I actually found and bought some of the shoes that was on the list before. I hope you enjoyed this video, man. Let me know what your top 10 is. It could be Air Forces or not. Doesn't really matter. It could be shoes in general, Jordans, you know what I mean? Just Air Force One happened to be my favorite sneaker. Thank you a lot for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Leave a like. Subscribe. More videos are coming on the way for sure. And I'll see y'all in the next video, man. I'm out.